Hi, this is Church from Church's Intake. So I'm going to read still in Proverbs. We're going to go to what the wiles of a harlot, you know, a married woman. Yeah, we do have a lot of people today. They don't take marriages the right way. You know, they'll divorce in a heartbeat, you know what I'm saying? But you have to know about, you know, messing with these women out here in these streets, and also these men. Men can be harlots as well as women. And we living in a day and age that, you know, God wants you to be married. He wants you to find that right one, your significant other the right way. Especially if you're in the body of Christ, he wants you to find your kingdom spouse, more or less, your soulmate, something like that. Not just marry any old woman because she's pretty or whatever, or not just be with any old man because he has money. Those things do fade away. But if you have a real close relationship with someone that you truly love and they truly love you, and you guys built your establishment together, you know, and also gave yourselves to God to, you know, establish that, to make it whole, you know, honorable and holy, he will definitely honor a marriage. And he wants us kids to be married. He don't want you just to be out in these streets just messing with any old thing. So let's get into the word a little bit and we'll discuss. My son, keep my word and lay up my commandments with thee. Keep my commandments and live, and by my law as the apple of thine eye. Bind them upon thy fingers. Write them upon the table of thine heart. Say unto wisdom, thou art my sister, and call understanding thy kinswoman, that they may keep thee from the strange woman, from the stranger which flirteth with her words. For at the window of her house I look through my casement, and behold, among the simple ones, I discerned among the youths, a young man void of understanding passed through the streets near her corner, and he went the way of her house in the twilight, in the evening, in the black, in the dark night. And behold, there meet him a woman with the altar of a harlot and subtitle of heart. She is loud and stubborn. Her feet abide not in her house. Now is she without, now in the streets, and lieth in wait at every corner. So she caught him and kissed him, and with the impudent face said unto him, I have peace offerings with me. This day I paid my vows. Therefore come I forth to meet thee. Diligently I to seek thee, thy face, and I have found thee. I have decked my bed with coverings of temperance, and carved works with fine linen of Egypt. I have perfumed my bed with myrrh, aloes and cinnamons. Come, let us take our full fill of love into the morning. Let us salon ourselves with love, for the good man is not at home. He is going on a long journey. He hath taken a bag of money with him and will come home at a day appointed. With her much fair speech, she calls him to yield. With the flirting of her lips, she forced him. He goeth after her straightway, as an oxen goeth after a slaughter, or a fool to the correction of the stocks, till the durst strikes through his liver, to the dart strikes through his liver, as a bird hasteth to the snare, and knoweth not that it is for his life. Hearken unto me now, therefore, O ye children, and attend the word of my mouth. Let not thine heart decline to her ways. Go not astray in her paths, for she has cast down many wounded, yea, many strong men have been slain by her. Her house is the way to hell, going down the chambers of death. God bless the reading of his word. That's Proverbs chapter 7, 1 through 27. So let's talk about that. So there's a lot of infidels in this world today. I mean, a lot of people, you know, aren't really trustworthy. A lot of people, you know, I mean, they, you know, we have friends, you know, as a male, and you know, you have friends that, you know, are cheaters, if you want to call it that. And you know that there's other friends that you have, you know, they mess around all the time. And obviously, if they have a girlfriend, they got a side chick. And some of these dudes are married or been remarried and trying to get remarried again. And you just know that they are harlots, you know what I'm saying? And women too. These women that, you know, are easy going, easy to lay in a bed with, you know. You just know that, you know, they're easy to talk to. They'll be married. Some of these women, you can catch them at, you know, I guess, you know, I used to see a lot of these women at bars and such. You know, they have on a wedding ring and everything, be out with their girls and doing dirty deeds with their homegirls and stuff and acting like no one sees it, but God sees it all, you know what I mean? Like, and then you'll ask them, like, yo, where's your man at? Like, oh, he ain't around. Like, if he ain't here, or if these girls go on vacation, like, if I ain't home or whatever, like, I'm not on the land or whatever, you know, whatever I do in the secret, or not around him, and I'm out with my girls, it's a mess. And you know that these people are definite harlots, infidels. And when I was coming up, like, I never messed with a married woman, not that I would know of. And I would ask the Lord all the time, you know. And I used to be a party man. I used to be out there, man. And I used to be able to pull basically type any type of woman I kind of wanted. One thing was because I could dance really good. And another thing was I was very funny, you know. So it was kind of easy for me, you know. If you're a dancer and you can make a girl laugh, yeah, they say, you know, it's easy for them to, you know, to get them. It's, you know, that women are attracted. It's not even necessary, like, you got to be the best looking dude in the world. Like, you don't. You got to, you know, be able to talk to a woman. And some of these older women, when I used to go clubbing and everything else, when I used to live in the world, you would meet a lot of these older women. And I would talk to them. And I would find out, like, you know, if they were, like, married or divorced or whatever that may be.
Excuse me.
And I would, I would move according to that, you know what I mean? And then some of these other young girls, you know, you'll talk to them and everything, and you could see like a wedding band on them or whatever. But so a lot of these young boys, they don't care if they hit married women or not, you know what I mean? And they don't know the repercussions that, you know, what happens when you do mess with someone that's married, that's supposed to be, you know, they have a significant other, you know, they have a wedding band on and everything else like that, and they can tell you that they married, but some of these people, they don't even care about the marriage. And to God's eyes, he definitely cares, and actually he punishes those that, you know, mess with these married women and such. Or if you're a married man and you mess with another married woman or whatever, it's like you're messing up a whole household. You're messing up a kingdom in God's eyes, and God's definitely gonna repay you for, you know what I mean, what you're doing, your dirty deeds and everything else like that. And you're going to definitely reap what you sow, and it'll come. It's not like it comes like next day air, but bad things will transpire in your life, and you'll wonder why, and you'll forget about like, yo, you smashed that married woman, or you smashed that married man or whatever. And then these things do have to come back, you know what I mean? It's like, you know, It's the law. It's the spiritual law, you know what I mean? Like, that you gotta reap it. You gotta reap what you sow. And there's another thing that people should know about this too. It's like when you mess with a whole bunch of different women or different men, you get the spirit of these people. And people don't realize this, like, when I used to mess with certain people or whatever, you know, and you had, you know, sexual relations with them or whatever, like, sometimes I would feel so drained, and I'd be like, yo, what is this? And it didn't really dawn on me until, like, you know, later on down the road. I mean, like I said, I was single, and I would tell chicks single. I'll tell these chicks I was single, you know what I mean? Like, I never really was the one to be like, yo, I'm with someone, and then you're trying to cheat on the low, like, oh, I don't have a girl. Like, nah, I really wasn't kind of like that. I was always like blunt up, I was always blunt with these women, and I was always trying to be correct and tell the truth, you know what I mean? Because the truth is the only thing that they truly wanted to hear. And I would tell some of my friends, like, yo, you know, if you was just truthful with these girls, you know, it'd be easier for you. Like, you can actually get more girls by being truthful. And a lot of people didn't realize that. I'm like, yo, that's just a secret I could tell you. Like, yo, like, why do you? I'm like, yo, I just be honest. Honesty goes a long way. But still in all, I was honest, and I still did mess around with a lot of women, a lot of different women or whatever in my time when I was younger. And yeah, you're definitely dealing with a lot of familiar spirits, and people have to realize this. Like, some of the people that you might deal with might be a witch. They could be atheists, or, you know, they mess with different spirits. They could have a demon in them, and then you thinking you messing with this pretty, beautiful woman, and you could be messing with a straight demon. Like, you know what I mean? And you wondering why, like, you feeling like down, or you feeling depressed and everything like that. Like, these spirits can manifest on you and take over you. And good thing that God always had me covered. I always wore protection or whatever anytime. Like, I never was like any of my friends. Like, some of my friends didn't even use protection. I was just like, yo, bugging. But I always did. And I was always like, yo, listen, at the end of the day, God kept me covered from any type of spirits was trying to manifest on me, or any type of girl was trying to put like sex voodoo on me, or, you know, trying to curse me to fall in love with them or whatever like that. Like, these things are real. Like, people don't realize this, but when you open up that word, you'll find out real quick how real stuff is, because ain't nothing new under the sun. Like, and people got to realize that too. Like, if there's nothing new under the sun, right, and these people out here, you know what I mean, messing around with a whole bunch of different people. Like, just think of certain people that you might deal with. Dealing, you never know. Like, if you meet someone at the club or something, man, they can be messing with a whole bunch of demons. You know what I mean? They can be over here under possession or whatever. And now you dealing and you having sexual relations with this person. And you're exchanging spirits with this person. You know what I mean? Your flesh going inside of them and they going and coming inside of you. Like, these spirits can manifest on top of you and they could subdue you if you don't have a relationship or a protection type. You know what I mean? Like, God was my protection. Like, Jesus always been my protection. You know what I mean? Even when I was living in sin, like, he was always there. And I'm glad I never got, you know, cursed or anything like that. Like, there's a lot of dudes today. Some of you guys is married to something that is a witch. You know what I mean? They cursed you and you fell in love with a witch. And yeah, like, the curse is about to be broken soon, because anything that was done in the dark and under witchcraft or whatever, like, God's going to expose that. You know what I mean? And a lot of people, he's going to wake a lot of people up now. And a lot of people, you know, some of you people got married to a significant other not knowing that you was under a spell. And it goes deep, man. Like, some of these women, you know, like, they are obsessed with certain men, so they would do anything in their grasp to get that man that they could be obsessed with. And if you know these things, man, you would move a little different. Like, don't just mess with any old woman. Like, I mean, if you of the world and you in the world, I mean, I get it. But yeah, y'all could be under possession too, you know. You could see it on people. You know, like, it's just like, yo, how did these two ended up being together? And you don't even know, like, the back lines. You don't even know that, yeah, that person could have been under a spell or something. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, and people got to put this into play. And not just think, like, yo, that you can't be bewitched, because you can. Or you can manifest the spirit that's within them by you having sexual relations with them. Now they got you. You know what I mean? Now you in bondage to them because of the sex that they gave you. Now you trapped in lust. And people got to understand these things, because these things are definitely things that we war against. We wrestle not against flesh and blood. Like, you don't wrestle against the human. You wrestle against the spirits that's manifested in these humans. You know what I'm saying? And if you start to look at it like that, you'll probably think a little bit different about, you know, meeting a person. But if you're a child of God, you know what I mean, you should definitely always take it up to God, even though you might be attracted to this woman or not. You know what I'm saying? Or you just wanted to have some type of fun. You got to know the repercussions of that fun that you might have. That might be your demise. You know what I'm saying? That person could also give you a sexually transmitted disease, and that's here nor there. But yeah, people need to start to be more mindful of things and realizing, like, how deep this stuff is. You know what I mean? That people are witches out here. People are warlocks out here. And they mess with spirituality. A lot of people messing with crystals over here, trying to say, you know what I mean, they want to be in a third eye and manifesting like garbage. You know what I'm saying? And it's just like they working on demon time. But you thinking it's like, oh, I've been enlightened, and it's like you've been bewitched. So you need to learn these things, because we wrestle, we in a spiritual warfare right now as we speak. And I feel for these young ones out here now, because witchcraft and sorcery is at an all-time high now. And people have got to start to know these things, start to observe and to absorb, knowing that people do have familiar spirits in them. Some of them are dormant and some of them are really out here going wild on certain people. So, yeah, it's starting to get a little dark out here. I'm going to let that one rest right now. And I'm going to say subscribe to Church's Intake. We can get into these words, man. Start talking about other things, too. As soon as the subscription, you know, as soon as I get enough subscribers, They start telling me what they want to hear, man. I start going in. But like I said, one when I first started this pod, you know, or this ministry or this TV show or whatever you want to call it, I know I had put out one about the president, you know what I mean? And I got that knocked straight down, you know what I'm saying? And it's like kind of crazy with the things that they don't want me to say. So I try to be smooth about the speech that I bring to this platform because of, you know, the enemy is always lurking, looking, and we got watchers all over the place that's trying to see your next move. So, and you know, he is the power of air. You need to know that we on air right now. So God bless y'all. Subscribe to Church's Intake.